I have been reading so much lately, and I'm so sorry I haven't made a video. It's because I made these goals this year to reread Harry Potter and finish reading Game of Thrones. I'm on the 6th book of Harry Potter, and I'm on the last book of Game of Thrones. Sorry, A Song of Ice and Fire, for those of us that have read the books. I'm in that category now of awesome. And I've been so busy doing that, and I can't review Harry Potter because everyone's read Harry Potter. That would be boring. And I can't review A Song of Ice and Fire because I haven't finished it yet. So I am stuck with that. But recently, I decided to pick up a new book. I'm a huge fan of Chloe Grace Moretz, and I was following her on Instagram because she is so lovely. And she had posted that she was fighting aliens all day on the set of The Fifth Wave. And I thought, I have heard of that before. When I worked in the bookstore, I stocked that book often, and I never picked it up to read it. Because I was thinking when I was like, oh, another alien book, you know, whatever. But they've been adapting so many YA novels now into movies, and I thought I should read this because I'll probably see it, and I can't go see a movie that I know is based on a book if I haven't read the book. It is against the rules for me. I will not do it. So I picked it up and read it, and sucked in immediately. It took me 2 days to finish. I loved it. So I want to talk to you guys about that. Basically, the premise is alien invasion and end of the world type jib-jab, but what really sells me on this book isn't the overused plot. It is a little bit selling on the point of originality in the overused alien end of the world Armageddon plot, but what I really, really loved was the characters. Don't you just love that when the character is different than you, like, some books you read and it's like they say something and you're like, I knew they were gonna say that, you know? Like, you get these ideas in your head of how the characters are gonna be, because everything feels so similar now. And Chloe Grace Moretz's character, and Cassie, who is our main character, there's a few different narratives in here, but Cassie's definitely our main character. I loved her. I thought she was such a badass, and she was so funny too. Like, she said things that I was like, right on, that's hilarious. And I loved the way she thought and the way that she processed things, and I just thought it was just such a freaking great book, and I was so excited when I was reading it, and I just couldn't put it down. And it just got better and better. There was this whole mystery with the aliens and what they were there for, and it was just very cool. And I liked the first few switches in narratives really threw me off. We get some narratives from Cassie's younger brother, narratives from her old high school crush, Bren Parrish, and narratives from an alien himself. So that was pretty interesting. And what makes an alien? I mean, it totally goes back to Sirius Black's, to bring up Harry Potter again. The world isn't split into good people and Death Eaters. Just like the world wouldn't be split into good people and aliens. You know, there's good and bad in everyone and everything. And I think that premise shone through very well. And it was such a great mystery and thrill, and I loved it so much. And I'm super excited for the movie. Hopefully I don't fuck it up. They fucked up so many lately. A good adaptation they did lately, though, was The Maze Runner, which I thought was very good. Made enough money to get going for a sequel, so that was good. I think I'm just keeping my expectations low on all YA adaptions ever since City of Bones, which was such a disaster. Heard they're making it into a TV show, though, so pretty excited about that. I think it'd do well as a TV show. Much better than a movie. Too much to explain in the Shadowhunter world. But anyway, back to The Fifth Wave. I thought it was great, amazing characters, great plot. The only thing I didn't really like was the romance in it. I just felt like it was out of place. Of course I liked it. I love romance in books. I'm a girl and whatever. I like it, so fuck you. And it's great. But I thought that in this instance it just didn't fit very well. But still interesting side to Cassie and the aliens and her crush and everything. It was great. So I recommend it if you're looking for something YA that's paranormal, that has a little bit of romance in it. Isn't that what all the kids are reading these days anyway? that's it. Enjoy this review. Pick up The Fifth Wave by Rick Yancey. I will be reading the sequel, which is The Infinite Sea, I believe. Came out this September, and I'm picking that up pretty soon because I want to know what the fuck happens next. So, yeah, there was a lot of swearing in this. Sorry, I get worse. I get worse with age. I'll be 25 on Saturday. It's so old, so gross. And stop caring about swearing and stuff. Okay, more book reviews soon. Once I finish Game of Thrones and rereading Harry Potter, I will be here to review. Thanks for you. Okay, bye.